Hi there, Maurice here with the Resuscitation Coach. In this video, we will discuss the ACLS Systematic Approach based on the 2025 American Heart Association guidelines. I will include a link to all the AHA algorithms in the description below. Healthcare professionals should use a systematic approach to ensure nothing is missed during a patient assessment. The American Heart Association systematic approach includes three components once you have established scene safety and your initial impression of the patient. The BLS assessment, the primary assessment, and lastly, the secondary assessment. When deciding which assessment to use for a patient, start with a step we all do automatically. Visually assess if the patient is conscious or unconscious. This is our initial impression of the patient. We can form a rapid general impression by a quick visual assessment of responsiveness, breathing, and color to determine the urgency of the situation. If the patient appears unconscious, use the BLS assessment before progressing to the primary and then secondary assessments. If the patient is conscious, go directly to the primary assessments and then the secondary assessments. The first step in the BLS sequence is to check for a response. Tap and shout, "Hey, hey, hey, are you okay?" Check simultaneously for a pulse and breathing for 5 to 10 seconds. If the patient is not breathing or has no pulse, immediately activate your local emergency response system and begin high-quality CPR, beginning with compressions. As soon as possible, attach a defibrillator and, if indicated, deliver a shock. If you determine the patient is not breathing normally but has a pulse, bypass chest compressions and support the patient by ventilating once every 6 seconds. If the patient has a pulse and is breathing, move to the primary assessment. In some cases, BLS will result in ROSC, but sometimes cardiac arrest persists, requiring us to continue with more advanced invasive measures. This is when you should follow the primary assessment and secondary assessment. Another time to use the primary and secondary assessment is if a patient is conscious. You can easily remember the steps of the primary assessment by thinking A, B, C, D, and E. Keep in mind that although these steps are listed in progressive order, the resuscitation team often performs them simultaneously. Airway, open, maintain, and protect. For unconscious patients, consider inserting an advanced airway. Regardless of the device chosen, the team must ensure proper placement and use continuous waveform capnography to monitor effectiveness. Conscious patients can often maintain the integrity of their own airway, and we need only ensure patency. Breathing. If the patient is not in cardiac arrest, we should assist ventilations as needed, once every 6 seconds. If the patient does not require assisted ventilation, we can support the patient by administering oxygen as needed. Circulation. Obtain intravenous or intraosseous access if IV is not possible. Attach the ECG monitor. identify the rhythm, monitor the heart rate and blood pressure, and give appropriate drugs to manage abnormal rhythms. Our ABC steps provide a continuous stream of information about a patient's condition. Disability. This involves checking for neurological function, quickly assess for responsiveness, level of consciousness, and pupil dilation. A quick tool that we can use to evaluate neurological status is AFPU. Alert, voice, pain, and unresponsive. Finally, exposure involves exposing the patient. Remove clothing so that we can perform a physical examination looking for obvious signs of trauma, bleeding, burns, unusual markings, or medical alert bracelets. Our secondary assessment involves obtaining a focus patient history. We can use the memory aid sample, which stands for signs and symptoms, allergies, medication and the last time taken, past medical history, especially those related to the current illness, last meal consumed, and events leading up to the current situation. The HSNTs provides us a possible diagnosis and interventions for our patient. H. Hypoxia occurs when inadequate oxygen reaches the body's tissues. Hydrogen ion or acidosis is the accumulation of acid and hydrogen ions in the blood and bloody tissues. Hypothermia is when the body temperature drops below 35 degrees Celsius. Hypokalemia is low blood potassium. Hyperkalemia is an abnormally high concentration of potassium ions. And hypovolemia is low blood volume. T's. Tension pneumothorax results from an abnormal accumulation of air in the pleural space. Pulmonary thrombosis or pulmonary embolism is a blood clot from a large vein that breaks off and travels to the pulmonary artery where it becomes lodged. Thrombosis coronary is a blood clot that forms with a blood vessel of the coronary system. Tamponade is a condition caused by an accumulation of fluid between the heart and the pericardium. Toxins may be best discovered by a focus history. The goal of the BLS, primary and secondary assessments are interventions that stop a patient downward spiral. If you benefited from this video, kindly like, subscribe, and smash that notification bell. We'll see you in our next review video. Have a fantastic day.